Come on, Ronaldo, we gotta go pick up the dates. Dates?
You guys got dates? You didn't think to get me one, did you?
Consider yourself lucky, Zip. You see, we're stuck with these girls.
Yeah, we got a couple of gorgeous dates, but you get to pick from a bevy of beauties.
Yes, Zippy, it's a 60s party. Relive those fabulous days of yesteryear. Remember miniskirts? Not even Tricky Dick could forget free love.
I love cheap dates.
Well, Zipper, it's all yours for the taking. All you have to do is go to that party and rock out.
It's no use, guys. You guys know I'm no good at parties.
So what are you gonna do? You gonna stay here all night and blow bubbles and fall out of bed?
It can be fun if you do it right.
Zipper, you don't make it at parties for one reason. You are dull, with a capital, dull. Add some color to your life. Hold on to that. I see you look beautiful.
Ronald, come on, we're late, huh?
Hey, I don't need this thing to make me look stupid.
No one can argue with that.
I like it.
Hey, girls, here comes Mr. Cool.
Susie Cooper, how you doing?
I got a proposition to make to you that you will not be able to refuse.
No.
No, I haven't even asked you. What, you still got the hots for Checo?
No, we're just friends.
That's good, because here's the plan. We go to my room.
Forget it, Zipper. I've got a date.
Whoever he is, I'm better.
He's a B student.
If I'm a D student, what's in a letter?
He's handsome.
He'll break your heart, baby.
He's right behind you.
He'll break my head. Well, you two go out and have a wonderful time.
It's always nice talking to you, Stanley.
You too, Susie. Nice to have seen you as well. Oh, nice legs, Mary Lee.
Nah, they're stunning, you little fungus.
Hi, you remember me? That's a yes. I'll be in my room. And the social mores of the 60s were simply a
part. Why, Mr. Crandall, what a pleasant surprise. It's so nice to see you tonight. Why don't you come right in here? How are you doing? Miss Crandall.
Mr. Crandall, it's a pleasure to have you here, sir. I knew for
sure. And the crabgrass boy, get it?
Got it. Swell. Now, just because I happen to own this little old college doesn't mean that I can come barging in on you kids anytime I feel like now, does it? On the other hand, who is going to stop me?
None of us will, sir. It's always a pleasure.
I was talking, boy.
Don't interrupt the president, honey.
My, that little girl is just too good for you.
Yeah, he knows that.
Now, my little girl, Charlene here, wants to have some fun. Understand y'all having a party.
A party, sir? Why, here, sir? No, sir, we're simply having a discussion here, sir.
Oh, now, my Charlene had her heart set on a party.
Welcome to the party, sir.
What Charlene wants is a fine, old-fashioned, all-American good time.
Well, don't you worry none, sir. She's in good hands, sir. Oh, not my hands, sir. I simply meant that I'll see she has a good time without having too good a time, sir.
My Harlan will take all the responsibility.
All right. The job is yours, son. You just take good care of my little girl. Now, sweetheart, you can stay out as late as you want.
Oh, thank you, Daddy.
Oh, Bunchkins. Just be home by 10:30. I got some important people at that party I want you to meet.
Well, goodbye, Mr. Crandall. It's always a pleasure to see you, and I hope
great.
You do drop by.
Great. Dana Mooney looks just like my third wife.
Really? What a handsome woman.
Mm-hmm.
You know, she run off with my bulldog.
Charlene, we'll have a peachy keen discussion on the social significance of the 60s and how they affected... He's gone. Music! Time, Charlene?
No.
Good, good. Let's go look at the trophy.
I want to meet some boys. Sugar Puss, could I talk to you for a minute?
Not now. I'm talking to Charlene.
He'll only be a minute, dear. Harlan, this music is making me warm.
We'll drink some ice water, Marilyn.
Harlan? I'm talking kissy poo warm.
Oh, my. No, look, I have a responsibility towards Charlene.
Harlan, I said kissy poo! Look, I have an idea. Why don't you introduce her to Seymour over there? You know that Seymour never leaves his food, and that way you'll always know where she is.
Charlene, I'd like to introduce you to a very nice boy, Seymour. Seymour.
There's no food here.
Nobody's going to touch your food. I simply wanted to introduce you to Charlene and have you keep an eye on her for me, all right? Good boy, Seymour.
Kissy poo. Hiya, Seymour. I'm Charlene. Do you want to talk? Oh, Seymour, stop fooling around with that silly sandwich. Let's dance.
Here, take this and go away.
Nobody knows the trouble I've seen. Nobody knows my sorrow. Nobody knows the trouble I've seen. Oh, yeah. This is too much.
Little know what's the right would be nice. That's crazy. That's the spot. That's so... Wait a second. Something's definitely wrong here. You're a girl. And a good one, too.
It's nice of someone to notice. Oh, I hope you don't mind my touching you.
Mind? Me mind? I don't mind. Here, I'll prove it. Do it some more.
You know, it's always been a fantasy of mine to rob someone. You know, my father would kill me if he knew I was here.
Oh, who cares? What, does he run the place or something? Use your nails.
Go out with guys.
What's left? It doesn't matter. I'm a guy. You got me. Rub. Bite me if it'll make you happy.
But my father would go crazy if he knew I was here with you.
Look, let me give you a piece of advice. You gotta sort of stand up to the old buzzard. If you don't, I will. Here. Now let's get back to fantasies. Wait a minute, do you want to eat a candy bar off my chest? Peanut brittle?
No. But now that you mention it, there is something I've always wanted to try, but I never had the nerve.
Oh, have the nerve. Please don't let anything go wrong.
I'm gonna need a feather and something to lie on.
Thank you!
That girl is 1 hour late. Charlene? Oh, she's
late. Lost, sir. Sir, sorry, sir. Get lost, sir.
Have you seen my daughter?
Not since freshman orientation, sir.
How about you? Have you seen my daughter?
Is this her?
All right, that does it. Where is my daughter?
Why, Mr. Crandall, sir, welcome back, sir.
You!
We were just to start a dissertation on
you,
the...
You, I ought to put you on a spit and roast you for Sunday dinner.
Well, sir, I
mean, I left Charlene in your care. Where is she at now?
I left her for just a second, sir. Isn't that right, Mary Lee?
Oh, that was a bad mistake, Harlan.
She's okay, sir. I swear it.
I have to get back to my party, boy. But you better go look for my little girl. And if she's with some boy, his behind is in a sling right next to yours. Do you get it?
I got it.
You better had. Lord, I sure miss that bulldog.
Hey, what a great feeling, Ronaldo. For once, somebody's in trouble and it's not us.
Yeah, I know what you mean. I would just hate to be the guy caught with Crandall's daughter tonight.
Oy vey.
Beautiful. A hair color that actually gives you healthy-looking hair. The hair color is Clarès from Clairol, the world's first no-ammonia shampoo in hair color. Clarès put in silky conditioners, so you actually get healthy-looking hair as you color. Give yourself the hair you deserve. Now, salon-tested color and beautiful, healthy-looking hair. Clarès from Clairol, the world's first no-ammonia shampoo in hair color.
Mmm, smells nice, clean. New shampoo?
Body on tap.
Body on tap, the beer-enriched shampoo for super body, super hold, and the shine of your life.
Brewed with one-third real beer.
Wow.
But don't drink it. Just shampoo. Whether I pin it, roll it, curl it, or blow it dry. Body on tap gives me super body.
Super body.
Super hold.
Beer-enriched body on tap shampoo for a beautiful head.
And the shine of your life.
Be one with us.
Can they make a beautiful fashion model the sentinel of hell?
Am I in a dream?
No. I mean, I thought it was a dream too, but it's not. See, I'm Sitting Bull. She's lying flat. Some sort of Indian meditation thing or something. It's her fantasy, not mine.
Zipper, your squaw is Charlene Crandall. Charlene Crandall.
I know.
Name mean anything to you.
Crandall. I think it means we're in a lot of trouble if that's Larry Crandall's wife.
She's his daughter.
Well, that's good, because I love her.
He's gonna kill the guy she's with.
Let's throw her out the window.
No.
We can't throw her out the window. Yeah, we can throw her out the window. We can cover her up with garbage.
I got a better idea. What we will do is, we will take her to her room and sneak her in. But you've got to be the decoy, Zipper.
I hate that idea. Let's take her to the garbage dump. They don't pick up till 6.
Ladies and gentlemen, what I am talking about is my pride and joy. And I don't just mean these new boots either. No. What I'm talking about is Crandall Coliseum, capacity 60,000. I tell you, no longer will our teams have to play their home games in the parking lot. What do you want?
Hi, Mr. Crandall. You don't mind if I call you Larry, do you? Okay, Lar. I think I can tell you exactly where your daughter is.
Oh, well then, start talking, boy.
You people can all take a break now if you like.
My daughter, please.
Oh, sure thing. Wait a second, have you got an extra cigar on you?
Well,
I see one right here.
All right, now you wait right here, boy, don't you move.
No rush.
Hello? Oh, yes. Hello, Governor. No, sir. Oh, no, indeed. That stadium is going to have every safety feature you could imagine. Yes, Byron, it will even have a bar.
Psst,
yes, indeed.
Zipper!
Look, a little coliseum. Little trees. Little referees. Don't do that. No. Little goalposts.
Fix it.
talk to you too, Governor.
Right.
Now then, boy, you were telling me about my daughter.
Larry. You're so impatient. First the amenities. Ah, Dean Jagger. Dean Rusk. How are you? Dean Memminger, glad to see you again. Look a little pale, boys. Us getting together, sitting around, talking with other peoples and stuff.
Yes, yes, I know. It's quite a shock to his wife. His wife ran off with his bulldog.
On the other hand...
Believe it's true.
Well, Mr. Crandall, Larry, I think you're going to have to admit this party's petering out pretty badly. Let's all go over to Lulu's place.
Enough of this filibuster, boy. Just where is my daughter?
Daughter?
Yes.
You thought I said daughter? I didn't say daughter. I said I found your quarter. Quarter! Quarter! I got it here. Well, I got 17 cents. I can get the rest for you Monday.
Lawrence, I think there's someone in your closet.
What?
Yes.
Are you going to listen to this drunk? Listen, Dean, sit down. You don't know your limit.
Now, why are you there, boy?
Get away from there, Mr. Crandall. I'll take care of everything. It's no sneezing there. See? No sneezing there at all. Must have been him. We found her.
Do we get a reward?
It is a good thing that I booted your mother out years ago so she'd never see you like this, you hussy.
Daddy, there really wasn't anything...
You are going to stay strictly within my sight until one of my boots starts whistling Dixley. Let me tell you that.
Whistling Dixley.
Get it? I said, do you get it?
No, I don't get it. You are going to get it this time. You and me are going to have ourselves a little showdown. I'll talk. You listen for a change. I shall be awaiting for you upstairs.
Thanks for telling me what to say, Zipper.
Zipper? Did she say Zipper? All right, now let me tell you boys something. When I come back down these stairs, I want to see the responsible party sitting right here in this chair, because I'm going to eat him alive.
Oh, we're in trouble. We're in trouble.
You! What are you three doing in Mr. Crandall's house? Well, see, the old geezer went upstairs. He's going to come down. He's going to give us a piece.
His thanks. You see, what we're doing here, Harlan, is we're celebrating. That's what we're doing. We are honored guests.
Yeah, that's right, Harlan. The old man can't thank us enough. We just found his daughter and brought her home for him. Ha! Thank you! Ha! Why you? I'm the one who tore my brand new double knits looking for her. Too bad, Harlan. That's the way life is. So long, big boy. And I missed an emergency meeting of the Young Republicans.
Jeez, life is rough, huh? But it's not our decision. So long, Harlan.
Oh, no. I'm not leaving. I am not as dumb as I look. I am president of this fraternity, and I'm sticking around to get my share of the credit.
Well, Harlan, in that case, if you insist on staying, have a seat.
Allow me, Harley. I think I'll do just that. Before I forget, the old man asked us to open up this rare bottle of brandy, but being the Piscudnik I am, I couldn't get the stopper out. Give me that. You know, breeding always shows through.
Glass.
You should let this be a lesson to you boys. Yeah, use me as a model. You know, I didn't get to become president of this fraternity because I'm a fool, you know. I mean, when old Wee Diesel Face comes down here, you boys just stay in the background and I'll handle everything.
So?
Hello, Mr. Weasel, sir. Or Mr. Crandall, sir.
You must be the responsible party.
Yes, sir. I don't care what they told you. Whatever it was, forget it. It was all my doing. Boys, you did the honorable thing. I'm proud of you. You saved my life.
Yeah, well, don't go spreading it around, Harlan.
What a wonderful feeling. There I was with Larry Crandall's fingers around my throat when you guys stepped in and put your neck in my noose. You see, being good paid off. You were hardly punished.
Hardly punished? We mowed Arizona.
We painted the entire campus.
We had to housebreak his new bulldog, Jasper. He ate my socks.
Socks can be replaced. The important thing is, you guys stood up for a friend.
You got it wrong, Harlan. We stood up for you.
Now you're picking nits. Despite the fact, you guys came back and told the truth. You know, I've always considered you guys Neanderthals, but last night, I felt that you both behaved like fine young men.
Thank you. It makes it all worth it.
I can see by that look in your eyes, you're pondering, what if the floor shine were on the other foot? Would I have put my neck in a noose for you? Well, let me say this. There comes a time when being a pie brother is much more important than petty personal differences. So my answer to that question is simply,
ha! Hey, Ronaldo, now come on. A beating isn't gonna change him any.
Yeah, why should I hit him? You're the guy that said, hey, let's do the right thing.
I did. No violence.
What violence? I just want you to help me to the room. Where's the...
Last time I saw him, he was painting a flagpole. Started at the bottom.
Bottom? Well, that should keep him busy till I'm ready to see him again. Isn't friendship wonderful?
Though the taste of oranges can differ from season to season, you can always count on the fresh, delicious taste of 100% pure Minute Maid.
That's because they blend the juice of different kinds of oranges for that special, fresh Minute Maid taste every time.
It's a taste your family will love. I know mine does.
Minute Maid. Goodness you can taste.
This man leads an...
Coming up next, enjoy the premiere of Turnabout, starring John Shuck and Sharon Bless, the hilarious story of a young couple who wish they could change places with each other, and do. Then don't miss the premiere of Hello, Larry, starring McLean Stevenson as a radio talk show host. He's a whiz on the air, but gets plenty of static from two teenage daughters at home. Hello, Larry's followed by the premiere of Sweepstakes. Catch it all tonight on NBC.